Hello everyone, BruceGoneLoose at your service, and today I want to talk about Steam. Steam has always been a source of controversy for the visual novel scene. Visual novel publishers typically have to fight with Steam just to get their titles accepted for various reasons. And besides being a massive pain in the fucking ass, the review process is incredibly inconsistent, leading to titles with plenty of sus content, such as Sex with Hitler, getting on Steam no problem. But then you have visual novels such as yuzusoft's most recent title, Tenshi Souzou RE-BOOT, getting denied. Why? Who the fuck knows? I could state the obvious offenders here, but again, it's nothing that isn't already existent on the platform. So today, we're gonna talk about it. And you might be asking yourself, why does this all matter? It's important to uphold companies to previously maintained standards. At least I'd like to state that, but when it comes to the Steam review process, it never had any standards to begin with. Steam, by and large, has absolutely no consistency when it comes to their review process of visual novel and anime games, and frankly, it's completely unfair. Steam is known to have a bias against anime content, and whether or not it's just a couple of their game reviewers that have these notions, they need to sort their shit out. Whilst yuzusoft's Tenshi Souzou RE-BOOT getting rejected is frustrating, it's not the first visual novel that had problems getting on Steam, and it probably won't be the last. Spike Chunsoft's Chaos Head Noah had trouble getting on Steam, leading them to canceling the Steam launch altogether. But after Valve re-examined the visual novel with zero changes, mind you, they accepted it. This is just one of the many examples of Steam's blatant inconsistency from their review staff. However, many visual novels aren't that lucky. Depending on the content, an outside patch has to be provided from the developer to get the full experience. The most notorious examples of this are Nukitashi and Wonderful Every Day, where they pretty much cut the entire fucking visual novel and you're left with like an hour or two of content without the patch. Other examples of visual novels being gutted are usually more content specific. In the case of Ninki Seiyuu, How to Make a Pop Voice Actress, they just nuked Konatsu's route, in lieu of her being the protagonist's full sister. Fair enough, I guess. If I want a sister route, I'll go play My Little Sister's Special Place, available on Steam. In most cases, though, it's just the H content and ecchi scenes that get the axe. However, whilst in some cases developers will provide extra content for their all-ages versions of their visual novels they're forced to make, it's not always a guarantee. If you want your hentai fix, go to the hentai section on Steam like the rest of us sinners do. Not that there's very much good there. And fundamentally, okay, I get it. A lot of Japanese visual novels take place in high school, and they have characters that look like this, and all characters appearing in this game are over the age of 18 splash screen, or a character's backstory, like, actually, this character is 1,000 years old and is a sword who looks young, as that's how she presents her spiritual form, or some shit, isn't very convincing. But if Steam is so worried about loli content, incest content, sexual content, they should A, be more consistent on their stance, and B, train their damn game reviewers to adhere to it, because the allure of getting on to Steam is immeasurable. But Bruce, you may exclaim, what about Jast? What about Manga Gamer? There's nothing wrong with them, they're good. In fact, many people prefer to use these storefronts, and I myself often use them when I can't get a visual novel on Steam. I reiterate, when I can't get a visual novel on Steam. I'm not here to take some righteous moral stance against Steam. I fully admit that Steam is my preferred place to buy my games, and when I can't get a game or visual novel on Steam, I feel less incentive to buy it. And I'm probably not the only one who feels that way. In general, I find visual novel fans more passionate than fans of other genres, and a visual novel not being on Steam won't stop them from seeking it out. However, it's Steam's ease of use that attracts users to it, and it's Steam's user count and product visibility that drives developers to it. For the foreseeable future, I highly doubt Steam will ever lose its number one spot. Epic spent billions gunning for it, and they failed miserably. but with Valve's untouchable monopoly as an online gaming storefront, they should at least consider being more reasonable to fans of anime and visual novel content, because people will and are finding alternatives. And that's money and reputation lost on Valve's part. Sure, it's very likely that NekoNyan will get Tenshi Souzou Reboot through the next time they submit the visual novel. But it's frustrating that predefined release dates become indefinite delays, all because Steam is a platform that cannot be consistent with the review process or very communicative in this whole review process. I think that's it for today. Bit of a short video, but I wanted to put something out. Let me know what you think about this whole situation with Steam, or whether you're looking forward to Tenshi Souzou Reboot. The premise looks interesting to me, so I'll probably be giving it a go. Anyway, thanks for watching, and you know what to do if you like the content. You know what to do, right?